One more to go.
He's ready to go. Good afternoon, everyone. Just a reminder, if you have not gotten the program yet, the hymns are on a special program for this week and next week. And we kindly ask that you return them at the end of Mass because we will use them again next week. There are four hymns on the sheet, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and those are the hymns we'll be singing this morning. Thank you. Happy Easter. And the entrance in is Christ the Lord is risen today, number one.
This man God raised for the third day and granted that he be visible, not to the whole people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with them after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Where they The number one resurrection is the very basis of our Christian faith, our basis of our Christian life. Because if Jesus had not risen from the dead, why should we gather here for the Sunday church? If Jesus had not risen from the dead, why should we have the sacrament celebrated in the church? If Jesus has not risen from the dead, why should we follow a Christian way of life? It is because we believe in the resurrection. That's why in the Creed we say, I do believe in the resurrection after the death. And that's why St. Paul, when writing, says, if Jesus did not rise from the dead, our preaching is in vain. If Jesus is not risen, then your faith is in vain. How true it is. It is because Jesus rose from the dead that gives us the real strength of faith, focusing on Jesus who is alive in our midst. And therefore, we see the second thing, Jesus' resurrection. Is assures of our own resurrection. Our own resurrection. When he was talking to Mary and Martha in Bethany, he said, all those who believe in me, even though dying, they will come home. So all those who die will never die when they believe. So then, that rather is the assurances of our own resurrection that we all will one day rise from the dead and join Jesus in his glory. That is inevitable things in our following Jesus. And then this resurrection, Jesus gives us a hope, gives us the real encouragement in our Christian life. We always say there is a light at the end of the tunnel. Maybe we are affected by illnesses. Maybe we are affected by so many conflicts. So many we face persecution. In all this, resurrection gives us hope and encouragement in our Christian life. Just imagine, I just tell you an event. After the Columbine High School massacre, King Laurie, one of the CNN reporters, just had a light interview with one of the girls from the school who survived from the massacre. He was there sitting with the girl. The girl became so nervous. Then she said, one thing I can never forget in my life, the girl's name was Maggie Payne. This girl told the reporter, the killer went into the classroom and asked one question, if there is anybody who believes in Jesus. There's a girl, my name is Casey. Yes, I do believe in Christ, my Savior. This killer immediately shot him to death. What a terrible event. So we ask, well, why should we make such a sacrifice? I just imagine in the centuries, the martyrs, the saints, they had such a sacrifice in their life. No matter what persecution, no matter what suffering, they just cling on to Jesus. And therefore, finally, we see how the resurrection becomes a meaning of all our prayers. We come to pray. We come to pray to Jesus, not a person, a fictional person, an imaginary person, but we come and pray to a person who is alive, who is rather hearing us, who is rather listening to our prayers. Jesus is not only alive, he is within us, leading us, guiding us, enlightening us in our way to prayer. And therefore, resurrection gives us the meaning for our prayer that we make to Jesus, who is alive in us, who is alive in the world, who is alive in the universe. And therefore, let Easter celebration not remain just in the total level, it must go deeper into our life, because resurrection means no end of life. Resurrection means no end of now. It is a continuation. If so, we should firmly believe in the tomb, just believe in the tomb of sin, in the tomb of happiness, in the tomb of anger, hatred. We should never be buried in doubt, but rather always remember the prayers of St. Francis. Because of the resurrection, where there is doubt, we must show faith. Where there is hatred, we have shown doubt. Where there is hunger, we rather show the real joy. And therefore, let the joy of resurrection continues in our life. We said, this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Yes, resurrection is the one by which Jesus has risen. Let us rejoice and be glad always. Amen.
who have died may enter into the joy of eternal life, especially for Joseph E. McGough, whom this Mass is being offered. We pray to the Lord. In silence, we recall our own personal intentions and the intentions of those who requested in our prayers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our glory and Father, we thank you for the resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, by which we are delivered to a new life in our Christian faith. Hear the promises we offer you in the same way with the Lord forever and ever.
In our offertory hymn on the special program is number 2. At the Lamb's side piece in the worship.
Thank you.
still need a certain type of work. And please support the back of the church. Again, we thank you for those in need. Directors will close on Monday, April 10th. There will be no holidays on Tuesday, April 11th, and resume on Tuesday, April 18th. Please move our body directors to God. If you'd like to go anywhere, please see why it's back of the church. Limited space is available. We ask you please put football missiles on the shelves of the back of the church, not to use. Thank you. She said that she was again like the return of the basket to be used up again in the next week. Again, on behalf of Father John, just want to hear about the attendance to Anthony, would like to assume your family and request it.
Thank you. Thank you.